brought to you by 2K Sports. Hi, everybody. Gary Thorne, Steve Phillips, and John Kruk. A veteran pitcher. Even when he doesn't have his good stuff, he can still make it a tough day on hitters. We're going to watch Kyle Pravano. A beautiful night in Chicago. Wrigley Field, our site for this game. Starting pitcher for the Cubs, here he is. So, Steve, what's the consensus as he takes a look at this Miami lineup about what he's got to do?
This lineup should not be much of a problem for this righty on the mound today. He has some of the best stuff in the game, one of the elite pitchers. He should be able to go through them easily and retire outs.
We'll take a moment to look at the Marlins lineup. Scouting Big John, who are we looking at today?
Boss Gonzalez is your typical old-school shortstop. Not a big guy, not a fast guy. He's not a guy that's going to hit 30 home runs, but he's going to make every play in the field one more consistent fielder. Plus, he's a pretty good contact hitter who hitting at the bottom of the lineup is what you need to get on base in front of the other guys who can move him around.
Our leadoff batter will be one here
for the Miami Marlins. Center fielder, number 9. Juan Pierre.
Pryor sets and throws. That's at the knees for a called strike.
Well, get this guy in the situation, Gary, you've got to go with the changeup.
Strike two. Pierre now has got to be careful, but a good punch hitter.
He gets two quick strikes on the hitter, but he can't be too selective now. He's got to go right at him.
And misses at the shins, 1-2. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Picked up by Gonzalez.
Out.
One down. Got a chance to check out the Cubs' defense as they're out on the field.
When you take a look at this club defensively, the thing to remember is they're ranked in the bottom five for the total number of errors committed. That's a lot of mistakes and a lot of extra base runners and bases that they've given up.
It's going to be Castillo now. That swung on and flied to right.
Now
two down here in the inning.
They almost got through there. They played the percentages shifting the outfield to the left. He hit it to right, but they were able to regroup and run it down.
And here's Ivan Rodriguez. Pryor sets and throws. There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground. And he'll step on first to retire the side. The kind of inning the defense likes, three up, three down. And the Cubs, their first chance coming up. Now we'll take a look at the starting pitcher for Miami. As he gets into this Cub lineup, Steve, what are we talking about strategy-wise?
Well, for Carl Pavano, good to see him healthy and pitching again. Good command and control with his fastball and a very good changeup. And he added a cutter to get in on the hands of the lefties.
That swung on and hit. Cabrera is going to play it. One away. Now let's take a look at that lineup of the Cubs. Thoughts, John? Anybody stand up?
Well, a guy that can do it on both sides of the ball, Aramis Ramirez, a great defender at third base, but also a guy who can supply a lot of pop in the middle of the lineup. Look for him to try to go deep today.
Got a chance to check out the Marlins now. Here's how they look defensively. So, John, any individual stand up?
But when you get a guy like Derek Lee, it makes the entire infield better. Talk to any infielder he's ever played with. They know all they have to do is get it within that large wingspan of his, no matter if it's high, low, in the dirt, wherever. And Derek Lee's going to come up with it and save his team a bunch of errors.
Drill towards third. And low over the catch.
And Gary, I tell you what, I think he caught that one in self-defense. He couldn't even move. He had to just get the glove up.
It's Sosa at the plate. Steve, his name oftentimes on that lineup card when you check out the offensive plan. Ball. And Pavano tries inside. It's going to be a ball.
Trying to throw it in on the hitter's hands right here. Trying to get him to flinch and open up. He just laid off the pitch, didn't get the strike.
Inside with a fastball, 2-0. Here's the pitch. Big swing and a miss as his eyes lit up on that pitch, but a 2-1 count. Swinging a ground ball, foul, pass first. The slider swung out and missed. Struck him out, side gun. And a quick inning for Carl Pavano. He gets through the first inning without allowing a hit. And it'll be the Marlins coming right up. Lead of the lineup coming to the plate. And here's Miguel Cabrera to lead it off. Over his career, a 359 off the Cubs. That's it. Pretty well down the line and left. And a lose there. As he drops back and puts it away.
Third base, number 19, Mike Lowell.
It's going to be Lowell.
The Cubs really struggled against the top National League East last year. Just about everybody in baseball would say the NL East, the toughest division in the National League.
Watches the off-speed pitch, ends up 0-1. For the Cubs, in those games against the National League East, the real demise came against Philadelphia, John.
And I don't see that East division getting weaker anytime soon. Certainly not at the top of the division. So the rest of the National League has their work cut out for them if they're going to keep up.
He lets that fastball go by for a called strike, 0-2.
He's a free swinger on the 0-2 count, so you've got to think to yourself, don't give him anything too good to hit.
Swung on, hit softly towards the hole. And he steps on first. That's the second out.
First baseman, number 25, Derek Lee.
Now with two outs, chance for Derek Lee. Hitting 250 lifetime against the Cubs. Prior sets and throws. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Unless you stay back and really think about going the other way, you've got no chance of hitting that four-seamer down and away.
And he swings and hits this one foul. That one swung on, hit in the air, deep to left field. And that'll do it as Alou puts it away. And they go quietly offensively in this half inning, nothing across. Both teams still looking for their first run in Chicago. And if you were just tuning in, hi, Gary Thorne along with John Crux, Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. Alou batting now. He'll start the home half of the second. Swings and misses the slider, 0-1.
Well, now that he's in the hole and behind, I suspect we're going to see a heater coming in there.
And the 0-1 by Pavano. Hot shot towards the hole. And he'll step on first for out number one.
Third baseman, number 16, Ramirez.
One away as Aramis Ramirez gets set.
Well, there's no more Florida Marlins, right? We now are going Miami Marlins. No more teal, no more F on that jerseys. It's transitioned away. The new team, new brand, and hopefully a better season.
Here's the pitch. Watches a fastball that's in there. 0-1. And what a way to go into their new digs. The Marlins have spent the money. They've been the talk of the offseason regarding the free agents that they picked up, Steve.
Well, they've been building for this year, right? To go into a new stadium.
Hit up the middle. Whoa, get out of the way of that one. Straight back up the middle. Out number two.
Chicago Park. First base. Number 32.
In there, their first baseman. On the ground to second, played by Castillo. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. Only five pitches to get out of that inning. That'll rest you. No production yet from the Cubs. It'll be the bottom third of the order coming to the plate.
For the Miami
and Encarnacion's batting. He'll start things off here in the third inning.
Encarnacion.
Fouled away.
Foul!
Swing and a shot down the left field line. And that's in there. The Marlins, their first man on. This one rolls through to the wall.
At
he stops
plate,
at second. That will
Marlins.
Be a double. He's
shortstop.
In scoring position now with nobody out.
Well, these kind of hits right here, a double with no outs to start an inning, really puts the pitcher at a disadvantage and puts a lot of added pressure on that pitcher. Now a single can bring home a run.
Gonzalez at the plate, hitting 229 lifetime off the Cubs.
And it just seems like there's always that one team that you struggle against, and this happens to be the team for him.
A bouncing ball to shortstop. One away.
For the Miami Marlins. Pitcher number 45.
It's going to be Pavano. Well, the opportunity is here. Pitcher in a spot right now. You get two outs to work with, and you got the top of the order coming up. Man on second, one away. Hit in the air to left center. And Gonzalez. Two men have been put away.
For the Miami Marlins. Center fielder.
Runner on at second. RBI opportunity now. Juan Pierre. Numbers over his career. 255 off the Cubs. And the first pitch. Swung on line to right center field. And it's through. Credit Pierre, a single. Here comes Encarnacion for the plate. And he's in there.
For the Miami
Well, right there, he just got a pitch he can handle. And he delivers a big RBI for the first run of the game.
Going to be Castillo now. Well, they've done themselves quite a job here. This is a nice push at this point of the ball game to get out in front.
Well, this lineup has to be very happy to get out to an early lead in this game. It builds their confidence and allows them to be more selective at the plate.
There's a throw over. Gets back in time. And here's the first one. Watches that fastball. That goes by him for a strike. And as we've seen so often in this game, you can never have too many. You get runs piled up early, sometimes the whole thing shuts down. So once you get this started, you want to keep going.
Exactly right. You want that early run support in the game because it does take the pressure off later. And hitters can go up there being a little bit.
There he goes towards second. 0-2. And he's in there at second base.
Oh, he had a great jump right there. Great acceleration. They couldn't get him with the throw.
That's a great secondary lead that allowed him to get in easily. Spins at a throw behind the runner. Trying to keep him close. He's back on the bag. This one's grounded to second. Grootsalonic. Throws the first, side is retired. One run, third inning. That'll break the scoreless tie. The Marlins lead 1-0.
The plate for the Chicago
Gonzalez Cubs. At the plate.
Number 8, Alex Gonzalez.
A shot up the middle. And that'll be in by the Cubs' first hit.
Well, anytime you get your first hitter up in the inning, big things could happen. It opens up a lot of holes in the defense, and it makes it a lot easier to hit for the guys behind you.
And Miller settles in. Lovano, the windup. Fastball just misses. 1-0.
Flat fastball right there, just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
Pauses, and now the 1-0. Hit up the middle. He picks it up. There's one. And a double play. They got a ball.
You have to love a great defense. I mean, that's an unbelievable effort right there. And a way to pick your team up in a critical situation.
And it gets the fans into the game, too. I think fans love D. And we're going to see Pryor here. Lovano, the windup. And it's fouled off.
Foul! Foul!
And that's another foul ball. Swinging an easy ground ball to short. Picked up by Gonzalez. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Marlins still enjoying this lead. And it's Yvonne Rodriguez to lead us off. Now, this is a kind of an interesting breakdown. You take a look at the pitch types that were thrown that have been hit for a base hit or better. There's a swing and a ground ball. And that's going to be a base hit for Rodriguez. That will bring Miguel Cabrera up.
Well, a nice piece of hitting right there. You get on base to start the inning with no outs. And you know, all it does is you want to just keep the line moving if you're the guys behind him.
He flew out his last time up. First pitch on the way, swung on, hit, and Cabrera's got himself a hit. Good offensive chance here.
Well, he gets the curveball in the outer part of the plate, but he does a good job of not trying to pull it. He goes right back up the middle. Nice job.
It's going to be Lowell, 0 for 1 thus far. Going in the bullpen, that's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and it'll probably make the move to the pen.
No one out yet. Runners at first and second. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one.
And Pryor's pitch. Looked at for a strike. 0-1. Swung on, lined over the first baseman's head. And it's through. Single for Lowe. Rodriguez is heading home. Rodriguez scores. And Cabrera also comes on. He'll pull in the third. That's a two RBI three-bagger.
Well, now after giving up three straight hits, the manager has to start thinking about getting somebody up in the pen.
Derek Lee at the plate. Just one player picking up after another, Steve. This is a good offensive show going on, and they're climbing the ladder with it.
Boy, so many quality at-bats for this offense. The pitcher has to make a pitch here and slam this door shut, or this can get away from it.
Pryor sets and throws. Hit up the middle. Gerd Salada gets to it. That's one down. And Encarnacion's batting. He doubled and scored in his last trip to the plate. First pitch to him. Line shot into center field, and it's in there. Miami will score here. Boy, the continuation here of this offense is called big time momentum.
You know, he usually has a lot of trouble with these pitches away from him, but he did a good job of staying patient and not trying to do too much to hit that ball and get on base.
And Gonzalez settles in for his AB. First pitch. Line drive. That's foul towards first. Oh, and one. Pryor kicks and delivers. And he scoops it up. The second, there's one. Back to first, not in time. Not quick enough on the relay.
They get the lead runner at second base, but I think they would have liked to have gotten two right there.
It's going to be Pavano. Last time up, blew out. First pitch on the way. Ground ball to short, and Gonzalez picks it up. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this happening. They pick up four hits in the inning and three runs across the plate. Marlins on top by four. What a clear night here in Chicago at Wrigley Field. This historic ballpark with so many memories on nights just like this. Lofton at the plate. This one's popped in the air, drifting towards the right side. And it's caught by Castillo.
Second baseman, number 11.
It's going to be Gerd Salonik.
Well, it was a bit of a redemption year for Carl Pavano the season before last. Had a great 2010 where he was able to stay healthy and get back to winning ways. 2011, he didn't quite have the same luck.
Here we go. Here's the first pitch. Here's one. Hit very well deep. This one towards Pierre. He comes up with it easily here. So Pavano, can he continue where he ended? He was better at the end of the season than he was at the start last year. He hopes that moves into this year.
Well, you're right. I mean, the number's not quite the same in 2011. But what we do have now is two straight years for Carl Pavano where he stayed healthy. That's a very good sign. Look for him to bounce back in 2012.
And Rodriguez calls for the pitch. Swinging a high chopper towards the hole. Played by Castillo. Throws on the first, side is retired. Well, that's one way to keep the pitch count down. They wrap that inning up with three pitches. No production yet from the Cubs.
Up to the plate.
That is Juan Pierre now to lead it off. How's he delivering on these first pitches? Let's look and see.
Now when you go 0-1, you get 1-1. He's got 11 guys out in this game after going 0-1 in the count.
And we've got Marcos Mateo on the mound. He's been chosen to take over out there.
Well, this wasn't the type of start the pitcher wanted, or the manager wanted, or his team wanted. Now they've got to see if the bullpen can do a little bit better.
Pierre watches it for a strike.
A nice location with that fastball down in the zone. If he makes contact, it's going to be a ground ball.
One pitch, fastball, high, 2-1.
Well, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
2-1 on the way. Oh! And now Juan Pierre, the 3-1 count. Let's see if he wants the walk or cuts away here.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch. Just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. That's one away.
For the Miami Marlins. Second baseman, number one, Luis Castillo.
Going to be Castillo now. Grounded out his last time through. Here's the pitch, up the middle, and that does get down. Castillo a base hit. It'll bring Ivan Rodriguez to the plate.
Well, he did his job right there, getting on base. Now with one out, let's see if they can move him around and get him in scoring position.
Singled and scored his last time around. The first pitch, swing and a line to left. And in there, he's 2-for-3 today, and they can't cut it off. It'll roll to the wall. That'll bring Miguel Cabrera up.
A good piece of hitting right here. They shift the defense to the right. He says, fine, I'll go left. Base hit.
Take a look at the career numbers for Miguel Cabrera. Already on his way not only to a fantastic career, but pointing towards the Hall of Fame.
Now the first pitch. It's 0-1 as he swings and misses with that fastball. And Cabrera is still a very young player. You wonder what his final numbers are going to look like. He's already in his 10th season, however, as a big leaguer.
It's amazing. It feels like he's been around forever, yet he's still so young. A great hitter. Going to go down in history as one of the best hitters to ever play the game, and I believe a future Hall of Famer.
And with two strikes on him now, Cabrera needs to be protective of that zone. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. It gets down, and that's going to drive in Castillo. Rodriguez trying for third. A little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen. Excellent base running right there, getting himself into second base. Great read on his part, and love the aggressiveness.
And you've got to decide what you're going to do in those situations before you ever get to first base, and that's what he did.
And that's what he did. You know what? Aggressive, taking that turn exactly the way he needed to, never missing a beat.
It's going to be low. Well, they definitely got a rhythm going right now, each player feeding off the other.
Gary, they keep lumping the hits together. They keep pulling away right now. This thing could be soon out of reach.
And maybe, Steve, this one already is out of reach. They got to find some fortitude to get back into this thing. First pitch on the way. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. Now it's two away.
Stepping up to the plate for the Miami Marlins.
And here's Derek Lee looking to bring that run in.
Derek Lee.
Here's the pitch. This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. And a lose there. And that's the third out. That'll do it. Well, they scratch across a run. Three hits and a couple left on. Marlins up five. Big bats ready to make an appearance. And a lose in the box.
Number 18, Moise.
Here's the first pitch. Swung on and hit this one to Pierre. And he puts that one away. One down.
Gary, you know, he's settling into a groove right here. That's six in a row that he set down.
One away as Aramis Ramirez gets up.
And one of the more underrated third basemen in the game, in my opinion. Aramis Ramirez has been at it for a long time and always finds a way to produce every year.
A swing line to left center. And that's a base hit. Ramirez on board with the single. Talking about Ramirez, the RBI production, John, somehow, some way, gets him in.
Well, the reason why he can do it is because he's so disciplined at the plate. He doesn't strike out a whole lot, and for a power guy in this day and age, that's a rarity. He puts the ball in play, and with that power, he's going to produce a lot of home runs.
And he starts him out. And Pavano tries inside. Going to be a ball. Well, what types of pitches have been put in play here today? Here's a quick breakdown of exactly that.
This guy's four-seamer's been hit two.
Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. And Encarnacion. As he gets a little exercise that time.
Heading up to the plate for the Chicago Cubs. Shortstop.
Gonzalez at the plate. He singled his last
Gonzalez.
Trip. Ramirez takes his lead at first, and Gonzalez settles in for his AB, first pitch. Ball one started off the at-bat, it's 1-0. At the belt, the 1-0. Smashes that one towards the shortstop. Throws to first in time, that's three down. Powell Pavano, he's got it going right now. That's another inning with nothing up. He continues to put up those zeros, pitching deep into this ballgame. And it'll be the Marlins coming right up.
Batting for the Miami
and Encarnacion's batting. He'll get things started off as we go to the sixth.
Encarnacion.
The pitch. Put something off, and it swung on and missed. 0-1.
Boy, he just couldn't wait for that changeup to get in the strike zone. You can't try to chase it. You have to let it come to you.
Northsider, lead Cubby Blue.
The pitch. Swung on and ripped towards second. So that's going to bring up Alex Gonzalez.
Well, just what his team needed. He continues to swing a great bat. Three hits from now in this ballgame, and he's on with no outs.
Bounced into a fielder's choice his last time. And here's the first one. It's now 0-1. Watch that fastball go by. Good eye by Alex Gonzalez laying off it. Count is even.
But Gary, the numbers seem to indicate he likes to go fastball on a 1-1 count, trying to get back ahead again.
It's hit foul by Gonzalez.
Foul!
Bombers this ball. A soaring drive deep left center field. And home run, Miami. The production continues. Now with that two-run homer, they extend that lead to seven. It's going to be Pavano. Here's the first pitch. A line drive towards short. Tremendous catch by Gonzalez. Reaction time critical in this play if you're going to get it in the air.
You're not going to see many plays better than this one. The instant it leaves the bat, he reacts quickly and reaches out and makes the catch.
One out, and here's Juan Pierre. Trying again here, just one for three thus far. And starts him out here. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
That's an outstanding breaking ball for a strike on the inside part of the plate. It locked the hitter up. He just froze and couldn't swing at it.
Hit in the air. Now out number two.
For the Miami Marlins.
It's going to be Castillo now. 8 years in the majors. Here's the delivery. He swings, hits a ball to right field. And that's the third out. That'll do it. Well, they add a couple more runs here and extend their lead even further. The Marlins still up big. And Miller settles in. He'll lead off the bottom half of the sixth. And the first pitch. Pavano gets that one in there.
He looked like he was looking for a pitch out over the plate. That fastball down and in locked him up a little bit.
On the way. There is a swing and a liner. And Gonzalez picks it up. In time for the up.
For the Chicago Cubs. Pitcher number 57, Antonio Alfonseca.
Alfonseca has a turn in the walk. Steve, how about a look at what the pitcher's got done?
You know, you throw that fastball down, the hitter's got to go down and get it. And because he's changed their eye level, they just can't get down far enough. A lot of ground ball out.
Swung on and missed against Pavano's pitch. It's 0-1.
Foul!
And it goes foul. Here's the delivery. Change up that time. Swings and misses. That'll be strike three and two down.
His pitches complement one another. They work off of each other. And he used a tremendous sequence right there. 1-2-3, strikeout, see you later.
Lofton settles in. He popped out his last time. Here's the first one. Swings on that first pitch. Misses the fastball. 0-1.
Now, guys, what we've seen here today has been a dominating performance from Pavano.
Let's take a look here and see what his approach is against these hitters on the first pitch.
A textbook right here. I mean, take notes, everybody. First pitch strikes equals outs. He's retired 11 guys in this game after having gone 0-1 on the count.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Plays off that. Ball two.
Well, that's just some good old country hardball right there. Four-seam fastball up in the zone.
Here's the 2-1 pitch.
Foul!
That's a foul ball.
Oh.
tough pitch to lay off that time. Full count, 3-2.
Well, he's trying to run that fastball low and inside. Just couldn't quite pick up that corner. Didn't get the call.
Payoff pitch.
Oh!
And he swings and hits this one foul.
That's what you want to do. You want to have quality at bats, get that pitch count up. And I tell you what, he worked this pitcher. It's going to be tough for him to get this next hitter out after working that walk on so many pitches.
It's going to be Grudzielanek. Well, it's truly been a tremendous day on the mound for this man. Here's a breakdown of how he's been mixing up his locations, using that to his advantage.
I really like what we've seen from him. Move ball up and down, in and out, changing the eye level of the hitters.
And you got to do that. I mean, you think about his strategy, and his success today is a testament to how important it is to mix up your location.
Here's the first pitch. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. And then Garnacion's there to retire the side.
Outstanding effort so far in this one. Six shutout innings. Making pitches when he needs to. Defense helping him behind him. An outstanding team effort so far.
The Marlins still lead.
Now up to the plate.
And it's Ivan Rodriguez to lead us on. Two for three thus far. The first pitch. There's contact. He drove it well. One away.
Now up to the plate for the Miami Marlins. Left fielder, number 20, Miguel Cabrera.
And Miguel Cabrera to bat. Had an RBI double this last time. First pitch on the way. Fastball misses away. 1-0.
Nobody on base right now with one out. And that's what you need. You need outs. It may be a break from base runners for a little bit here. How about a quick inning to get back in and score some runs?
He delivers. Swing liner back up the middle. And in there for a base hit. He's 3-for-4 today.
Now, well, anytime you're a hitter and you can get three hits in a game, you're going to see that average start creeping up to where you want it to be. And he's on now with one out.
It's going to be Lowell. Blew out last time. The pitch. Ball is blasted, a long high drive deep to center field, and home run, Miami. The production continues. Two-run homer just adds to a terrific hitting game they've had. Derek Lee digs in, one out. Here's the first pitch. Ball one. Steve, this lineup combined with their pitching right now in a position to be unstoppable.
Well, no question about it. In the other dugout, the manager's got to be thinking, what am I going to do with this pitcher? Should I get him out of there?
Hit in the air to left center. He catches that, and that's out number two.
Right fielder, number 43, Juan Encarnacion.
And Encarnacion's batting. He's a perfect 3-for-3 in the ballgame. Sandy starts him out. Up the middle it goes. Picked up by Gonzalez. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. Well, they are losing in this ball game. Not sure what they think about the guy on the mound, but they got two up in the pen.
I don't know what the rush is to get him out of there. He still looks fresh. He's had some problems in the game, but I think he can regroup still.
And they add a couple more runs here and extend their lead even further. The Marlins still up big.
Now up to the plate.
It's Sosa at the plate. Cubs. And here's a quick summary of how this guy's mixing up his pitches. How's he doing?
Well, when you're playing behind a guy, you love to see him mix up his pitches, change speeds. But when you're in the batter's box, it can create a lot of havoc for the hitter. He's done a great job of that today.
Yeah, for the most part, he's been keeping the hitters guessing, not knowing or anticipating what pitch they're going to get. He's able to change it up no matter what the count.
Smack that one. Long fly ball, but it's a foul to the left. And Rodriguez is calling for the pitch. Taps this one foul off to the left. One-two pitch coming. And he fouls off another one. The pitch. That one goes foul. And he fouls another one off.
But what you're looking for when you're behind in a count is you hope the pitcher makes a mistake. In this case, though, he didn't. He made a great pitch down in the strike zone. But give the hitter credit. He gets up on that bat a little bit, choking up, and keeps it in play to keep the at-bat alive.
There's a swing. Line drive, center field. That one gets through for a base hit.
Well, you wonder he had the energy to run to first base after seeing that many pitches, fouling off pitches, taking tough pitches, but he did. Well, thank goodness he only had to run 90 feet because I'd imagine he was pretty tired.
And the lose in the box. Last time up, flew up. First pitch to him. And it's fouled away. Misses for a ball to even things at one.
Now, Gary, it's tough to score when you only get three hits. We're deep into this ball game, and they have just not been able to mount any pressure against him today.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And he watches the low pitch delivered by Bovano.
Listen, he's not one to get too fancy. 2-1 count. He's going to come with a fastball. I'm betting on it.
The 2-1 pitch. Here's a swing and a slow roller up the middle. That's one out, and they turn the double play.
Beautiful looking double play right there. Pitcher's best friend.
That shortens the inning, shortens the number of pitches that have to be thrown. It's all about defense. And Aramis Ramirez stands in. Two down. One for two in the ballgame. And the first pitch. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike.
Well, that's a solid pitch going up in the zone with that four-seam fastball. You establish different parts of the zone, and you change the hitter eye level. In this situation, he took the pitch.
Hit on the ground. Played by Castillo. Throws on to first. Side is retired.
Oh, he's absolutely mowing them down here today, Gary. And they haven't been able to muster any sort of offensive attack against them here at all.
No production yet from the Cubs. And for those of you catching up with us, hi. I'm Gary Thorne along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips, bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Gonzalez at the plate. Swing and a bouncing ball up the middle. Gonzalez. That's one away. Here's that replay. That close to making it a base hit.
Well, let's take a look at how close this really was. He's busting it all the way down the line, and they do just manage to nip him at first.
Nice call. It's going to be Pavano. 0 for 3 to this point.
Oh,
Pennant. Here's the pitch. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. That now one's glove.
For the Miami Marlins. Center fielder, number nine, Juan Pierre.
So two down. Here's Juan Pierre. He's had one hit, four times up. Now the first pitch. Back up the middle. And it's through. Credit Pierre, a single.
Now gotta love that first pitch fastball right where he wanted. He was thinking right back up the middle. Base hit the center.
Gonna be Castillo now. Throws over to first, keeping an eye on him at first. Pitch on the way. It's fouled off. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1.
Well, you know what? I mean, it hasn't been flawless, but so far, they'll take it. Less base runners than outs in an inning for a change.
The 1-1. There's a swing and a smash. And that's the third out. That'll do it. No runs on a hit, and they'll strand. Marlins 9, the Cubs nothing. And the first baseman in. 0 for 2 thus far. Lovato, the windup. And that misses for a ball.
Tough to score with only three hits in a ball game, and we're deep into this one right now. So unless something dramatically changes, he's just going to shut them down the rest of the way. He's been overpowered.
He fouls that one off. Swing and a miss. He's behind a ball and two strikes.
But just because he's a fastball hitter doesn't mean you can't throw him a fastball. Strength on strength right there, and the pitcher came out ahead.
The 1-2 on its way. No swing, 2-2. Fastball is low that time. The count runs full.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Swung on and fouled away.
Ball! You can't keep the gun down. Get back.
Brings him up. You talk about dominance in a baseball game, you're seeing it here on the mound.
I tell you, there's not a hitter in this lineup that has a clue how to hit this guy.
What he wants now is that shutout. Gonzalez at the plate. Grounded out last time. And here's the first one. That one's high. Pavano doesn't fool him.
Well, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
The 1-0 now. Gonzalez watches it low for a ball.
Climbing the ladder with that four-seam fastball, trying to get the hitter to elevate his eyes. He gets the strike on it, and the hitter doesn't pull the trigger.
Come on, dummy.
2-1 delivery of fastball, begging for a call, strike two.
Well, he likes to swing 2-2. He gets that defensive two-strike approach.
He's going to try to put it in play. Let's see if he can make a pitcher's pitch.
Hit in the dirt. Gonzalez. That's the second out.
As a manager, you sit back and watch this guy out there dealing like that. The pitching coach just says, hey, go get him, buddy. You've got it completely under control.
Miller's at the plate. Grounded out his last time up. Here's the first pitch. And it's fouled off.
Foul!
Bovano, the windup.
Ball!
That misses for a ball. Here's the 1-1 pitch.
Ball!
Change up just off the block, and it's 2-1.
Well, that's where you look for a changeup from the pitcher away in the strike zone. If they look for it and get it, they can really shoot that thing the other way and do some damage.
Fastball on the block. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1. And the slider is in there, 3-2 now. Kicks, throws to Miller. Line drive fouled off towards first. And he fouls off another one.
Well, you know, the last thing the pitcher wants to do on a 3-2 count is to walk a guy. But give the pitcher credit. He still made a
ground ball towards second. And Castillo picks that one up. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning.
Guys get a chance to get in that dugout, take a deep breath, get his legs back underneath him, to find that energy to raise his level of performance to close it out.
No production yet from the Cubs. Things will start getting difficult with the third man in the order lurking ahead.
In the back for the Miami
and it's Ivan Rodriguez to lead us on. Had a couple of hits, four trips to the plate.
Rodriguez.
It's going to be Adam Russell on the mound as they make the pitching swap. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Well, if you're going to get a good fastball, you better pull the trigger a little sooner. You can't be late on that heater.
Oh!
It's hit foul by Rodriguez.
You're out!
And he can't make contact. Punch Rodriguez up empty on the swing.
That's a big, big breaker on this one. Sails in to 76 miles per hour.
It's down in the zone, but it's definitely a hittable pitch. Looks like the pitcher just caught him looking for something else, and it threw off his timing.
Outstanding work right there, John. And for the rest of the lineup, maybe they'll be second-guessing the next time around when they face him, especially with two strikes. Collinsworth up now. The pitch. Now here's a grounder towards the hole. And he steps on first. That's the second out. It's going to be Lowell. He homered back in the seventh inning of this game. First pitch on the way. Grounded to Ramirez. He grabs it. Throws to first in time. That's three down. Take a look down there at the bullpen. They've got a lefty up and throwing.
Well, I don't see him coming in just yet. I mean, with a righty in the on-deck circle, I don't think that's the matchup they want.
Quick half inning there. It's over. Five pitcher. Up next, it'll be the Cubs.
In the back.
Goodwin is the batter. Now the first batter here in the bottom half of the ninth. We'll see if he can get something going. Make this crowd happy.
As the pinch hitter comes into the game now, it officially closes the book on this guy's day.
And swung on and missed against Pavano's pitch. It's 0-1. Ball. And that misses for a ball.
Scouting reports indicate when the count is 1-1, he's really aggressive. So I'm being real careful on this pitch.
He watches the 1-1 pitch, takes a fastball, strike two. Putting two outs away from a shutout.
He's really showing us some kind of performance here, Gary. If he can finish this inning out as strong as he started, he's got it.
That's a strikeout that contributes in a big way towards winning the ballgame. As you can see here on the WPA graph. Lofton up now. Lofton, his last plate appearance. Here we go. Here's the first pitch. First pitch is a changeup. Looked at 0-1.
Okay, this guy really has trouble on off-speed pitches early in the count. Look for them to pull the string and throw him a changeup.
In there, and he falls behind 0-2.
This pitcher being very aggressive throwing strikes. I think he's going to try to get him to chase.
Here's the pitch. Change up, thought he had it, but it's 1-2.
Well, he's over the 80 pitch mark right now at this point in the game. And you know that pitching coach is keeping a close eye on him to see if he tires.
That's this one fouled to the right. Swung, ground ball to short. Picked up by Gonzalez. On the first, two away.
Chicago Cubs.
In this second offensive base. Era baseball, it's tough to come out with shutouts. But he's been phenomenally good today. On top of his game, looking to dig up for a little bit extra to get this last hitter out.
It's going to be Gerd Solanik. He flew out his last time up. And here's the first one. And that one is a fly ball. Do it. This one towards Pierre. And on that play, it comes to an end. And Steve, we get to witness one of those rare events, a shutout.
He was in absolute command right from the start. Gary, game like this doesn't come about without some solid defensive play, and he had that behind him.
And congratulations on the goose egg.
Fans going home unhappy in this one. Their offense just did not get it done as the opposing pitching just shut them down. Wow.
It's time now to recognize our player of the game.
Yeah, I mean, this guy came out and made this team look like world beaters today. A couple of hits and he went big fly. All in all, it adds up to a nice day's work and they come away on top.
And we got to see a terrific performance out of their starter, and he was able to ride that one on to victory.
Well, an outstanding effort. He had everything working today, the good stuff and location to shut down the opponent.
Thanks for being with us today. We hope you've enjoyed 2K Sports Major League Baseball. We wrap it up. I'm Gary Thorne with John Crux, Steve Phillips, and our 2K Sports group. We'll see you soon.